Are you ready to make your own customizable, completely editable planner sticker kit from scratch? Because in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create this really simple and beautiful functional planner sticker kit. We're going to add patterns. We're going to create a color palette. We're going to create different shapes to create these stickers. And of course, you'll be able to use the same techniques to create so many more. I'm also going to share with you all of the tools that I love and recommend for making stickers and how you can get this template that you can edit in minutes yourself too. So make sure you stay tuned and let's get started. Okay, here we are in Silhouette Studio and I'm going to be showing you how you can create this sticker sheet. So we've got some planner stickers here and you'll see from the basic shapes that we're using, you can actually create a lot more than these. But we're making some full boxes and some half boxes and some checklists too. And the designs that I'm using, if I zoom in, are some really cute hand-drawn Christmas baubles, and I'm going to show you at the end how you can access these too. So let's get started. The first thing that I'm going to do is just start a new canvas here, and I'm going to add the registration marks. So if the box isn't already open, just head up to the page setup panel on the top right, and then we're going to click on the third tab and choose to turn registration marks on. We want to make sure that all of our sticker designs are inside this red box and ideally not on the crisscross area too. So the first thing I'm going to do is draw my very first box, which is my full box sticker here. Now, full box stickers, if you're not used to using them, are really great to decorate your planner. They're also really good for sectioning off areas too, or even just filling in some white space. So the first thing I'm going to do is draw a rectangle. So on the left hand side, hover over drawing tools and click draw a rectangle. Now with your left mouse button, we're just going to draw a rough rectangle. There it is. And I'm going to zoom in here so I can see this closer. And now I want to change the size of this rectangle. So I'm clicking on it and on the right hand side, open the transform panel, click on the second tab, and here is where we can change the size. Now you can measure your planner so that you know the exact width and height of the stickers that you want to make. I'm going to go with some universal sizes today. So let's make the width of this 1.5 inches and the height 1.9, and then choose apply. Now this size will fit a planner such as an Erin Condren vertical. It will also fit into a classic happy planner and many others too. You could make it a little longer if you wanted to. But here we are with our first sticker. The next thing I want to do is add a pattern to this box. So remember, I'm going to share at the end how you can access the patterns I'm using today. But let's assume that you have already got them, that you've downloaded them, and you know where they are on your computer or laptop. Next, click Library. And here are mine. But what I want you to do is open a new folder where you can find it. And all we're going to do is find where you saved your patterns and then drag them into here. So this is a really quick way to be able to upload them. So I have my patterns here, and then you can just drag them over to the Silhouette Studio icon and then drop them into here. And I won't do that now because they're already there, but it would just add them into the library for me. Now this means when I go back to design and I've clicked on my shape, if I go to open the fill panel, click on the third tab and then scroll down, and they're in alphabetical order, so you need to know what name you've saved them as. Oh, I've gone past them. Here they are, and here are mine. So I'm going to click on one of them, and it's populated the shape with the pattern. Now, I want to zoom in on this pattern a little bit, so you can see here it's a bit closer, and I'm going to do the same thing here. So all I did was, where it says scale, I think I scaled that up to 300. There we go. Or you could even make it smaller. We can play around with the settings here, anything between 0 and 500 until you're happy with the size. And I want to have three more of these patterned full box stickers. So what you can do is right click and copy and paste, or click duplicate, or a quick thing to do is click on the box, hold down the control key on your keyboard and just press the right arrow. It's made another one, and right arrow again for another one, and then one more. Let's move these a little bit further apart. We're going to align everything neatly at the end. Okay, so let's give the other three a pattern too. So I'll choose that one. I'm just going to choose them randomly, that one. And let's go with that one. Okay, perfect. Now what we can do is create our next boxes. So underneath here you can see I've got some full boxes again, but this time instead of having a pattern, they actually have a full color and then they have a white rectangle inside them, and we can write on this rectangle. You can make a list or write your events or plans for the day. So again, I'm going to click on one of these full boxes. This time hold down control and press my down arrow. And what you could do is just click on multiple ones and again do the same thing, hold down control and press the down arrow. So now I have four more, but this time I'm going to give them a full color. My fill panel is still open, so let's click on the first box, go back to the first tab, then I want you to click on the color picker and you can pick any color from within these patterns above. So let's go with that dark blue. Love it. Okay, next one, maybe let's go with, just go with the same as the one above, so that mustardy brown, then we'll go with green, and then let's go with light green. It doesn't matter if it isn't exactly the same as the original sheet that I created. Okay, now I want to create another rectangle, but this time a white one, and it's going to go in the middle of this full box below. So let's go back to drawing tools, draw a rectangle, and let's start to draw our rectangle. We can see the red cut line there. And it's going to be a transparent one. So what I want to do now is just click on that new rectangle, change the fill to white, and then go to the line style panel here, go to line and change the line to transparent. Simple as that. Now let's select both the outside rectangle, the outside full box, and the new white rectangle. And I want to align them so that that inner rectangle is completely in the center. So on the right hand side, let's open the transform panel and let's click here to centrally align it. And it's slightly nudged it and it's done. Okay, perfect. I'm going to do the same thing now on each of the others, but a really quick thing I can do is just click on this white rectangle, hold down control and press my right arrow key on my keyboard 3 times until I have 3. Awesome. Okay, now I can just line them all up in the center of those. And they are done too. Okay, now we're going to do our half box stickers. So these half boxes are exactly the same as the top four boxes, but half the height. And again, they're really good for sectioning off your planner and just adding a bit of a pop there too. So we'll create these from scratch. So we're going to start by going back to drawing tools, drawing a rectangle. There it is, just a rough half box size. Now let's click on it. Let's open the, here we go, the transform panel. If it isn't already open, click that. Second tab, we're going to give this the width of 1.5 and the height of 0.95 this time. But remember again, you can check your planner and measure it to make sure that you're sizing it the right sizes to fit your exact planner. Let's move that one over here and I'm going to duplicate this one 3 more times. I want 3 altogether. Perfect. Okay, let's just move them along and same thing again. We're going to click each one in turn. Open the fill panel, the third tab, scroll down to where you've saved these bauble designs, there they are, and let's choose some different patterns this time. So let's go with that one and that one. Haven't used that one yet. What else haven't I used? Maybe that one. And again, we can click on them and we can scale them up until you're happy with how the pattern looks inside the shape. Let's do that one and maybe let's do 300 or maybe 200. What we can do as well, if we don't want them to all look the same, if I go back to one of these ones on the top, I can click on this one and choose pan pattern. And then can you see this little X in the middle? I can now click on that and hold it down and move my pattern within the shape. And if this is a seamless pattern, you can actually move it anywhere at all that you want. Let's go with there. Then it's going to look a little bit different to the one on the other side. Okay, so I've got my half boxes here. I might just scale that one up too. I don't want the design to be too small. And perfect. The last thing we're going to do is draw our checklists. Now, checklists are used by so many people in planners, certainly if you're a list maker like I am. So really, really common to use, and I think you'll enjoy using them too. So again, go to drawing tools, draw a rectangle, and let's do our rough rectangle shape. There we go. Let's click on it. Go back to the transform panel and to the second tab. We're going to give this a width of, I'd like to go 0.25, and the height, I like to do the same as my full box, 1.9. and choose apply. There it is. Let's position it over here. Now let's go to the fill panel and give this a color. I'm going with that blue. Okay, now I want to add my circles, my white circles inside to make this a checklist. So over to drawing tools on the left, click draw an ellipse, and then we're going to start to draw our little circle. Now we can see here it's an oval, but if I hold down the shift key at the same time, it will make it a perfect circle. So hold down shift, and when you're happy with it, let go of the mouse button, let go of shift. There we go. Let's give it the fill of white, but I want the cut line to be removed. So I'm going to go to the line style panel, the second tab, and I'm going to go transparent. Perfect. Now let's duplicate this so we can have, I think we'll fit 7 of these all together. So I'm going to duplicate it until I've got 7. Perfect. Now let's grab that bottom circle and drag it down to near the bottom. And then holding down the shift key, I'm going to click on each of my circles in turn until they're all selected. The next thing I want to do is space them out, so distribute them all vertically. So while they're selected, go over to the right hand side and open the transform panel, and then we can vertically space them. Now let's right click on them and group them together. And now I'm going to select both my checklist and my circles. And while I've still got the transform panel open, I'm going to align them all in the center, then right click and group. And now I have a checklist. And I'm going to duplicate these, so I think I'll have 16 altogether. So let's just click on that, hold down the control key, press my right arrow, and I'm going to keep on doing that until I've got 16 altogether. There we go. I'm going to drag this one over here. I want it to line up with my half box above. Then I can select all of my checklists and horizontally space them. Let's give them different colors though. We don't want them all to be the same. So I'm going to right click and ungroup them. And then I can click on them. I can either click them each in turn or hold down shift so I can click a couple of them in one go. Open the fill panel and let's choose the colors that we want to give them. So next let's go dark green. And then those two are going to be that pale green. Let's click those two, and we can go back to the beginning again, actually. So let's do those two. And if you wanted to, you could even give them a pattern. And then these last two are going to be the pale green. And there are my checklists done too. Let's just click this button up here, fit to window, so we can zoom out. Now you can see there's a lot of space here where we could add some more stickers, but the last thing I want to show you is how you can now arrange this sticker sheet so it's super neat. So what I'm going to do first of all is select, just imagine when you're looking at this screen that everything is in rows. So let's select the row of four boxes first, open the transform panel, make sure they're all aligned to the top, and then I'm going to distribute them horizontally. Now let's right click and group them together. And then same thing again. First of all, though, I want to just group each of my four boxes with the white rectangle in the middle as one, because I'm going to be doing the same, distributing them. So first of all, let's select them both, group them together. There we go. And then this last one, let's just select both of them. Right click, group. Now we can select our row of four boxes, align them to the top, distribute them horizontally. Right click and group that new row. Same with this one of the half boxes, vertically align them to the top, horizontally space them, right click, group. Same with these checklists. In fact, here I know that they're already all aligned, so I'm just going to select them all and then right click and group them together. The last thing I would do is just maybe space them a little bit further apart. Let's make the most of this full sticker sheet, of course. There's plenty of room here where you could even add some more stickers here. But let's say that our sticker sheet now is all finished, but we want to make sure they're aligned neatly. And let's say they currently look like this. We're going to select everything. We're now going to horizontally align them all to the center. Super neat. And then we're going to vertically space those rows of stickers. And our sticker sheet is now complete. And now I'm going to Control and P to print, and let's click print. And I'll print on my Canon printer. So I've got a Canon inkjet. You might want to increase the quality of the print by going to more settings and then changing print quality to high, and then okay, and then print. Okay, here's my printed sticker sheet, and I've got my silhouette cutting mat for my portrait. So I'm going to position this sheet onto the mat and smooth this down. And now this is going to go into my silhouette portrait. Okay, it's time to cut these out. So let's go to send. And then the second tab, the line tab, I'm going to deselect all the lines except for the red cut line. And I'm checking that it's only going around the outside edge of the stickers, and it is. So I'll be printing on white sticker paper. And now we're going to put in our settings so that we can kiss cut the stickers out. And then when you're ready, let's click send. We are all cut out and ready to go. So my stickers have cut out here. I've got my planner ready so I can start to use them to decorate. So let's see how they've cut. I'm going to test a full box first of all. And there we go. It's looking so good so far. I'm going to keep on going now and decorate my full planner pages. And I really hope you've enjoyed this class, learning to make those basic sticker shapes, to add color, to then use that pattern in the color to create a really cohesive color palette. And of course, then you've got this sticker template that you can reuse over and over and over again. Now, if you would like to grab this template, doors are open right now for you to join Secret Sticker Society, my sticker making membership, where every month you'll get brand new sticker making projects, done for you templates that you can edit and customize in minutes, and our fantastic support community. And we'd love to welcome you in so that we can get creative and crafty together every single month, one sticker at a time. I'm going to link below all of the tools I've used today and to Secret Sticker Society, and I hope you've thoroughly enjoyed learning to make these stickers.